Hi, this is James Cook, Assistant Professor of Social Science at the University of Maine at Augusta, and this quick how-to video is oriented for students who would like to create a concept map and then who would like to upload it so that their instructor can see it. So, we have a few internal links in this video. Click on them and you can learn in general about how to make a concept map. You can learn in particular how to make a concept map by sketching it on paper. Or follow this link to learn about how to create a concept map in Microsoft Word. And finally, click this link if you'd like to learn how to create a concept map in Google Docs.
In general, the idea of building a concept map is simple because concept maps are only made up of two kinds of objects. The concepts themselves, usually referred to as a circle or an oval with a label inside. Another concept, and some connection between the two concepts, with another label on top representing the substance of the connection. There's really nothing more to it. The trick is for you to build that concept map from the inside out. Dump your brain onto a sheet of paper, and you may be surprised about some of the ideas you have. To do this, the first thing you need to do is list your concepts. So think of a concept and write down a list of up to 20 words that are related to it. For example, if we have the concept of water, we could come up with this set of words: wet, hydrogen, oxygen, polar bonds, liquid, so on and so forth. You'll notice when I came up with this list, I didn't quite get to 20, and that's okay. The idea is that 20 is really a capper so that you don't have too much complexity. See what you can come up with when you build a concept map. Then, to build your concept map, in general, you place the central concept, the place you're starting from, in an oval at the top. Here we have water. Then, choose the three most importantly related concepts and put them in ovals beneath. This is your judgment call, and there is no right or wrong answer. You just pick the three concepts you've listed that you think relate most strongly to water. I've picked molecule, freezes, and boils. And then when in this small set, you then write out connections in the form of an arrow, usually a double-headed arrow, meaning that there's some kind of connection between molecule and water here. In this case, we would read this that molecule is a water, or water is a molecule. Which one makes more sense? The second. So that's what it means. The water relates to molecule because water is a kind of molecule. We would say water boils when it is hot. So the next step looks complicated, but it's really a replication of the prior step. You just take all the rest of those concepts in the list of 20. You place them in the map so that related concepts are close to one another. And then you connect and describe all the relationships between these subsidiary concepts, these lower level concepts. So you'll notice I've placed hydrogen and oxygen next to molecule. They're close. Why? Because there are connections there. Liquid is close to molecule. Why? Because there's a connection there. You'll notice that as we go down, that sometimes there will be concepts that are connected to two other concepts. Sometimes there are concepts that are only connected to one other concept. That's fine. Build the connections where you believe they ought to be. Once you've connected and described all these relationships, congratulations, you have a concept map.
Perhaps the simplest way of building a concept map is with a pen and paper. Simply write out the concepts that you have in mind, starting with your central concept. Lay them out, as you've just seen on this video, and circle them, connect them. Then with a
scanner or a good digital camera, take a picture of your work, make sure that it's legible, and head over to Blackboard to submit it by browsing for your picture file, selecting it, and hitting the submit button. To make a concept map in Microsoft Word, let's open a document and let's figure out how we can insert and change and type on shapes. To do that, we'll look up here at the top ribbon for insert. And we'll look for shapes. Pretty intuitive. We'll click on shapes, left click, and we'll look under basic shapes for oval. Now, to move into the main workspace, we'll notice the cursor has changed to a plus. Left click and then drag until your oval is just the right shape, the one that you like. And then to insert text, let's say our concept map is for a word processor, you simply type on the shape when it's selected. How do you know it's selected? You'll notice there are these little boxes around, 8 of them. Those boxes also, if you hover over them, allow you to change the shape of your oval some more. Pretty handy. What's more, you might not be able to see word processor right now, but if you select it, the text, you can change the size until it's just big enough. Oh no, well, what if your text is too big for the oval? Change the shape. Drag those little boxes after you left click on them and you'll get the right size. Now, once you have an oval that has the right size text and the right shape, the one you like, you'll want to make copies of it to make other concepts. How do you do that? Well, first make sure that you've selected your item, and you can do that by hovering over and clicking. Then head to the Home ribbon and look for the command copy. Once you click that, there's a copy saved for you to be able to paste. And you just use the paste command. Then, in order to move your item, your new concept, this copy will just hover over and then left click and then move your trackpad or mouse. Great. Now, what's another concept that might be connected to word processor? Computer, perhaps. Computer. What's another concept that might be associated? Well, let's make another copy. Copy and paste. And then let's move that over there. Perhaps writing is another concept. Good. So we need to now connect these items, neaten it up. There's a guideline. What can we connect them with? Well, let's head back to Insert, Shapes, and we'll use a double-headed arrow, not a line, because the double-headed arrow can be written on, the lines cannot. So you see this left-right arrow? You can find it under Block Arrows, or if you've used it before, recently used Shapes. Let's click on that, and then let's head back to our document, find a nice space, and we will left-click and then drag until we have a nice, big, fat, chunky arrow. And as with an oval, we can simply write on it. What connects word processor and computer? Word processor is a software package on a computer. Now, perhaps that text is too small. So again, we will increase the size by clicking the A up. Uh-oh. Well, now we need to do what? We need to change this, the something about the shape of the arrow in order to make it possible for all the words to be seen.
But there's a problem. You'll notice the arrows are not pointing to our ovals. How can we change that? At the top here is a rotation icon. Hover over it and you'll notice the cursor changes. Then left click and move your mouse or trackpad around in order to get it in the right angle. Then hover over the shape, left click, and drag your shape into just the right spot for you. We can now copy this shape, copy, and paste to make our second connection. And we'll hover over rotation to rotate it in the right angle. We'll move it to the right spot, and then we will change the words. What connects word processor and writing? A word processor is a tool for writing, perhaps. So we now have the elements in Microsoft Word for a concept map. To upload this, if you're a student who is participating in a concept mapping project, simply save. Find a place to save it, and you can save it as a concept map. Perhaps you might want to put your name on it and save it as a docx file. And then, as before, you can upload using the Blackboard tool on the internet. To create a concept map using Google Docs, you'll first need to access Google Docs. If you have a regular Gmail account, you can access it that way. If you have a University of Maine at Augusta account for all students and faculty, you can launch the portal and look for the odd triangle with three colors. That icon refers to Google, and Google Docs or Google Drive. They're becoming synonymous. You can look for a create button at the upper left, click it, and find drawing. So now we have a fresh drawing with nothing on it. We'd like to insert some shapes. So we could either click insert shape, or we could click on the shape icon. These two do the same thing. If we look under shapes, we'll notice one option is oval. Let's click that. And you'll notice that there is a plus icon. Left click it and drag it to create a shape that you like and a size that you like. Wonderful. You'll notice that there are a number of boxes surrounding it, about eight of them. Left click and drag on that, and you can change the size of your oval. And then if you would like to create a label for it, as you should for all concepts, perhaps the concept Google, simply start typing when you have your oval selected. You know you have your oval selected when you have boxes around it. To deselect, click something else. To select, just click on the oval again. If you'd like, you can increase the size so that it's very legible. You can also change the justification using the alignment features. Center it. And once you select it, you can head to edit and then copy and then again edit and paste to make a copy of your concept. To move it, select your oval, then left click, hold down that left button and drag, and now you have a copy that's placed. To change the title, double click on the title and change it. Now, what is Google? Some people would say it is cloud. Okay. And meaning that it's on the internet. How would we think about the relationship between these two? We could add a shape that, like a double-headed arrow, that allows us to think about the connection and describe it. Now, this arrow will be drawn left-right, but no worries.
after we create it, we'll notice that at the top there's a little button. If we click on it, hover over on it, so there's a plus sign, and click on it, hold that, and then drag it around, we can tilt that arrow, and then we can click on the arrow and drag it, holding that left button down again to move it into the right position. And let's try typing in it. Let's see what happens. Google lives in the cloud. Oh, perhaps we'd like to center that. And let's make it big. Okay. Now we can select a concept, copy it, and paste it to create a copy, then left click and drag to move. And perhaps we might want to think about cost as a concept. Then we could select our arrow, copy, and paste. Left click and drag to move, and then we'll want to look at that little rotation button, left click it, and drag around in order to change the rotation, and then again move it by selecting and left clicking. Okay, we could even change the width of it so that we're not overlapping the text too much by clicking on those little blue buttons and resizing. What's the relationship between Google and cost? Google has no direct cost. Okay, so now we have some elements for a concept map. Of course, you'll want to create more, but when you're done, you can give your drawing a name, my concept map sample. For instance, you might want to add your name. My name is James Cook. And of course, you'll want to send that to me eventually if you're one of my students. To do that, you might share it with me, but it's always nice to have a physical copy on your computer, especially if it's being graded. So you can download as under file. A PNG. PNG is a graphic format that can be read by anyone. Okay, and then once you have it saved to your computer, you can visit Blackboard to upload it and submit it to me directly.